Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see all about a full wave rectifier. So basically in the last tutorial, we have gone through half wave rectifier. Guys, please watch these three videos in series, guys. First go with half wave, then full, then bridge. Don't just mix them up, so that I'll be taking some factors from half wave and substituting in these things. So you need to pay concentration on that. So basically a full wave rectifier, I told you that it will be having two PN diodes, okay, and it consists of a transformer, and at the end you will get the output. So basically these two are interconnected, so that the diagram is really simple, guys. There's nothing much to confuse or nothing much to mess it up. So here we will be using a center tapped transformer, guys. A center tapped transformer is nothing but it will be having the equal number of windings on N on the primary and the secondary side. This will be our primary side. This will be our secondary side. Okay, guys. Okay. So basically a full wave rectifier, if the input is given like this, a positive cycle with a negative cycle, it's going to make both of them positive, guys. So that avoiding this, and it converts it into a positive cycle. Wow. That's really 100% plus point for this, right? It's far, far better than a half wave rectifier. Okay. So how does that happen? Shall we go through it right now, guys? Come on, let's do it. So basically in the first case, okay, I'll be drawing it in a paper, guys, as I didn't make these PDFs, so I need to make them. If this book is really messy, then how can you read, guys? So basically I'll be drawing the other side, guys, so that it will be clear for you. So basically the diode is like this. It is nothing but positive, negative, and here we are having a winding. And here we are having the another diode, okay, positive, negative. So in my first case, I'll be giving positive here and negative here. This will be my first case, first cycle, this cycle, positive and negative. So here it is matching up. So here it is forward bias, right? So we're gonna get a half cycle, and here it's a reverse bias. So we are not getting any output. So further moving on, in the second case, I'll be giving minus and I'll be giving positive. So here positive positive matches, and we're gonna get one more cycle. So the sum of this, we're gonna get something like this. Okay, so that's what is our output. So I went a bit fast, guys, because we have discussed all these things in our first tutorial on half wave rectifier. So now let us further move on our discussions. So now let me read the statements that you will be very clear with those. So rectifier is a device which converts AC signal to pulsating DC. Okay. This has two diodes D1 and D2. Yep. So further moving on, from name itself, you can say the full wave rectifier, both positive and negative cycles are converted into positive cycle. So during the positive half of D1 with respect to forward bias, okay, that will be forward bias, right? We have discussed that. Where the another diode D2 will be in reverse bias. So we gotta get the output this. So in the second case, when we apply the negative half cycle, D1 will be in reverse bias and D2 will be in forward bias. So we gonna get the second output. So we'll be getting this. So hence, we have just done the discussion all about the full rectifier, guys. We are done with it. So now, let us go back to some formulas. So basically, we have discussed about ripple factor. Ripple factor symbol is this, and is equals to under root VRMS by VDC whole square minus 1. Okay, so basically we need these VRMS and VDC values. So VDC is equals to 1 by pi integral 0 to pi Vm sin omega t d omega t. Integration of this is nothing but minus cos. So we got this. So substituting the limits, we got this. Okay, so here it is VDC. So we need to convert it into IDC if we want IDC. So basically V is equals to IR, I is equals to V by R. So basically IDC is equals to VDC by RL. So we can write VDC as 2VM by pi. So 2VM by pi RL is equals to 2IM by pi. So this is IDC. So further moving on, we need VRMS also. So basically VRMS is nothing but root mean square. So VRMS square is equals to 1 by pi integral 0 to pi, the square of the above term which we have took here. Vm square sin square omega t dt. So we'll be taking Vm square common. So as it consists no term with related to omega t. So we can take it common. So that We can write sine square theta, that's not sine square omega t, in the terms 1 minus cos omega t. We can write like that, guys. Cos 2 omega t. So now differentiation of cos is nothing but sine. So that's what we have just done here. So I have just substituted the values so that I got this. So once we apply these two values in our ripple factor, we're gonna get a value 0.482. So this is the ripple factor value of an half wave rectifier. So if you just observe to the previous, in that we got 1.21, guys. That's really a large thing. Okay. So but here we got really less, 0.8, 0.48. So only 48.2 of the AC supply is present. So a full wave rectifier is used in converting AC into pulsating DC. Right, guys? Okay, almost 50% is removed. Okay. So if we want to go to efficiency. Efficiency. What is efficiency, guys? Output by input. In output, we'll be getting DC supply. So DC output by AC input. So that's what we have just written here. VDC square by RL by VRMS square by RL. So once we substitute the values, we got 81.13. Wow, here the efficiency is almost double of the half wave. Okay, guys. So further moving on, peak factor. Peak factor is nothing but peak value by VRMS. Peak value is always constant. That is VM by VRMS is VM by root 2. So root 2 will be coming up. So that is 1.414. Fine. So form factor is nothing but VRMS by V average. That is equals to 1.11. Similarly, TUF is equals to 0.693. And peak inverse voltage is 2 VM. So now I hope everyone got a small idea. I hope this is really a short tutorial and we compare it with the previous tutorial. That's the reason why I discuss one topic in detailed and we'll be connecting all the topics in terms of that. Okay, guys. So now I hope everyone is now clear with it. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through bridge rectifier. Thank you. Thanks for watching.